ticketing automations, triggers, scheduler, and time tracking. In Settings, under Automation, first, you have Event Triggers. Here you can customize event triggers to perform functions automatically when specific events take place. You can create three types of event triggers. 1. Triggers to set ticket properties. 2. Triggers to assign technician or technician group, in order to assign ownership. 3. Advanced automation, where you can set up triggers to assign other actions such as sending an email notification and associating a runbook. In order to create a trigger, you can click on Create and choose the type of event trigger to be created. First, you can choose when the trigger has to scan tickets for the specified conditions. The trigger will scan for specified conditions when a new ticket is created. There is a new update on the ticket, change in priority, category, or cause, among other reasons. Every time you receive a reply from the client. And every time you send a response to the client. Then set up the conditions to be scanned for the trigger. Finally, choose the action to be performed and click Save. Up next, under Automation, you have Time Triggers. You can use time triggers to perform tasks automatically after a certain amount of time. For example, you can use time triggers to notify technicians if a ticket from a VIP client has been idle for 5 hours. In order to set up a time trigger, click on Create. First, you can choose the time frame for the trigger to commence. The trigger will be initiated after the specified time. Then, specify the conditions to be scanned for the time trigger. Finally, specify the actions to be performed and click Save. Next, under Automation, you have Ticket Scheduler. The Ticket Scheduler allows you to create recurring and scheduled tickets for routine maintenance tasks and one-time activities in the future. In order to set up a schedule, you can open the Ticket Scheduler and click on the Schedule Ticket option. Once you're in, first, you can choose whether you want the ticket to be scheduled only once or periodically. If you are creating the ticket to be scheduled periodically, then choose the conditions under which the schedule will take place. Once you are done, fill in the client details in the ticket form and give a name and description of the ticket. You can also add ticket properties that can help you prioritize the ticket. After filling in all the details, click on the Save button in the top right corner of the page. Additionally, you can choose to schedule a ticket while creating it. You can navigate to Create, click on Ticket. There, fill in client details and instead of Save, choose Schedule Ticket from the drop-down list. Finally, when it comes to time tracking, SuperOps provides the option to auto-start work log timer as soon as the technician opens his ticket, helping you to easily track and pull the true amount of time spent on tickets. In order to enable this option, you can navigate to Settings and click on Time Tracking under Contract and Billing. There you can set a default service item that you use. For example, labor charges or PC support. Enable the option to auto-start the timer and click on Save. Now, when the technician opens a ticket from his queue, the timer would start automatically. Also, you can easily keep track of your active timers by clicking on the timer icon on the pane to the left. This feature allows you to manage your running/pause timers without going to the specific ticket page every time.